Ooh.
Semarakkan semangat keusahawanan bersama aplikasi permainan Macun's Adventure. Muat turun di Google Play Store dan App Store.
Mau nak jadi jutawan?
Dah bersedia untuk cabaran sebenar? Sertailah Night Stream. Permainan tanpa jalan, tanpa had. Fungsi kawalan sepenuhnya. Inilah cabaran sebenar. Inilah Night Street, permainan larian generasi baru yang anda nantikan.
Attention! Attention! To all gamers out there, check this out!
Semarakkan semangat keusahawanan bersama aplikasi permainan Macho's Adventure. Muat turun di Google Play Store dan App Store.
Mau nak jadi jutawan?
Dah bersedia untuk cabaran sebenar? Sertailah Night Stream. Permainan tanpa jalan, tanpa had. Fungsi kawalan sepenuhnya. Inilah cabaran sebenar. Inilah Night Street, permainan larian generasi baru yang anda nantikan.
Attention! Attention! To all gamers out there, check this out!
Welcome back to another live streaming lounge on My Game On's Facebook page. As always, with me, Ken Osman. We are right here at KL Convention Center for Comic Fiesta 2018. And right beside me, we've got someone very talented, very passionate, and as you can see, very amazing looking with her cosplay costume. We've got Micho Teh!
Hi guys! Woo! Here.
So, Micho. You know, I gotta say that I was looking forward to meeting you because you never feel to disappoint at any of the Comic Fiestas, any of the cosplay events. You will come and impress.
You sure? No, are you
sure,
just like...
Sure, Micho, no, sure. Diva, sure one. Yes, I've been scrolling through all the pictures from the previous events. I'm like, I gotta meet Micho. But my biggest worry is if the set is not big enough for you because you have come with all the different weapons, the different add-ons that you have with you. So this year, what character are you here as?
Okay, so why I'm currently cosplaying is actually Crystal Maiden from Dota 2.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a mobile game, online mobile game.
Oh my god. Yeah. Look how Micho is rubbing in my face that I don't play Dota 2. It's a mobile game by the way, and also online game also. Yes, Micho, I know. I just didn't know about the characters only. So why don't you enlighten me about this character?
Actually, I started playing Dota 2 around 2014. It's a long 2014. Story, but yeah, I can start with the why I started Dota 2 and everything. Yeah. So I started playing Dota 2 in 2014, and then I fall in love. And Crystal Maiden is a support character in Dota 2.
Right.
And in the mobile game, it's very important to have like the balance in the team. So support is crucial. Wow. And no one wanted to play support in Southeast Asia server.
Really?
Yeah. So me is like, okay, lo, never mind. You guys don't want support, I support.
I support.
Yeah.
She wants to stand out among everybody else.
Yep.
If all Malaysians and all Southeast Asians don't want to play support, don't worry, Micho Teh to the rescue.
Yep.
So Micho, I want to talk a little bit more about cosplaying because I think this is just brilliant. This is my first year attending a cosplay event and I am so impressed. Yep. When I came here yesterday at 9 a.m., it was super full and I was like, this is only 9, you know? It was worse than an Ed Sheeran concert, to be honest with
yes,
you.
Yes, yes.
Crazy. But it really impresses me that this community is super supportive. They are very enthusiastic about coming to this event. So can I ask you, why did you start cosplaying in the first place?
Okay. It's actually because I enjoy like anime, gaming a lot since young. So when I first attend event in 2009, it's actually at Sunway Pyramid. It's also Comic Fiesta.
It's been 9 years, wow. Nine consecutive years attending this event.
So that time I was like, because I studying nearby Sunway Pyramid, and I was like, okay, drop by and have a look. Wow, amazed, because there's already cosplayers like, around.
Yeah.
So I was like, I want to be a part of them. I want to bring life into the character I love.
Yeah.
Because cosplay for me is to like, to show people, to like gather the fans, to dress up as your favorite character.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's really to show the love.
Exactly.
So yeah. So I like the character, I love the character, I play the character. That's why I started cosplay. I wanted to promote this game, this character, the love with other fans.
And when you put on your cosplay costumes, do you feel different than your usual self? Do you feel like you are escaping your reality?
Actually, I do sometimes. In a way, it's a bit similar like gaming. You play game, you not just gaming, you watch movie, any entertainment is a form of escapism
also,
right?
So true, I absolutely agree with you.
So cosplay, in a way, it is. And it's not involving just like what you see, like dressing up. Sometimes we craft the item ourselves. Like the wig, I have to style it myself. The costume, either I hand make it or I get tailor to do it, but I still need to modify. I do like all these things. Maybe you see this or this 3D printing.
Yeah.
You see this or this one. I go to hardware store and then to search the perfect material.
There's a lot of hard work there.
Yeah. So it's involving like craftsmanship and
And one thing I love about cosplaying that I just discovered yesterday, first day of Comic Fiesta, is the fact that you guys take months, sometimes years, to plan out one outfit. And in your case, how long did you take to come up with this whole look?
Okay, actually it's a very funny thing is that I saw someone selling this costume online at secondhand.
Yeah.
So I bought it over from her, but it didn't fit me at first. So
right.
I sent to modify everything,
alter
everything.
Yeah.
The prop, I also like fix it, remade, modify.
Let's show it to the people. I like to merasa, oh, it's so heavy. Oh my god, it's so heavy. Micho, you didn't tell me it's so heavy, Micho. Luckily,
only I
went to work out yesterday.
Yes.
If I didn't work out, I cannot manage the whole this, you know.
Ayo,
oh god, take it back, Micho. Take it back, take it back. So what about this one? How long do you work on this? What weapon do you call this?
Actually, it's her default like weapon stuff inside.
Right.
So there isn't really a name for it
that
I know.
Okay, why not Micho give it a special name? What if you could call this something, what would you call it?
The icy stuff.
Why not? The Micho icy stuff. I love it. Love it already. So basically, so how many months do you take again?
Okay, so because I have this costume, the base, and I also have this also as the base before, so modify and remake. I think it actually took years to get what I think that
my
is more
goodness.
Decent right now. This is the second week I had. I mean, not just this character, there's other characters that I also like debut and remake, or I get tailor to make in the same time. So sometimes I focus on this project, sometimes I focus on that. Yeah. So this took years lah.
And normally, on average, how much do you spend for a cosplay event?
Wow, you mean only on the costume?
On
making?
The costume, yeah.
The most expensive I ever spent, I think, few thousand.
How much?
Less than
2,000.
2-3 I think. Like, for example, one of the characters from Dota 2 is called Wind Ranger. She's like my most favorite hero.
Yeah.
And to get the, because she's like my favorite, I want to get it perfect. I had 3 weeks, I bought 3 weeks for her.
Wow.
I purposely, besides me making the things myself, I purposely get like those wig, prop master to make. I have like 2 bow which I own, I self-make. I also get like prop maker to make.
Cool.
And then I have like 2 set of costume just to get the one that I really want. So there's like thousands there to...
See my expression now, I'm like, whoa!
Yeah.
See guys, cosplaying is no play, it's no joke guys. It's a joint hard work, it's joint effort, months of hard work, and a lot of planning as well, and a lot of money coming out also. I think that's something that people don't really realize, that cosplaying actually incurs a lot of money as well.
Yep.
So what if there are people out there who really want to start cosplaying, but they feel like, oh no, what if I don't have enough money? Are there any tips that you can give those new cosplayers to save their money?
Actually, it's way easier to get into cosplay now compared to back then, compared to like 9 years ago.
Because the support wasn't that as big as it is now.
Yeah, and also nowadays, because online, you can online shopping.
That's right.
And a lot of people are like selling away their costume. So you can get like secondhand costume with a better, reasonable price.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can just get something that you think you like, or it's something that, it's very easy to get.
There are different options out there.
Yes. So yeah, any other tips? No part time, no work part time. Back then it's like that. You earn that money through part time or what?
Right.
Save that money. It's
because
the same,
if you love something, you would go the distance just to get it done, right?
Yeah. It's the same that you want to watch a movie, you want to buy a certain DVD, you want to go travel.
Absolutely.
You have to use your. You have to save it.
Absolutely agree with you. So, is there anything throughout your years as a cosplayer? Have you ever learned anything new about yourself as a cosplayer?
I guess it pushes my limit. I mean, not just as a cosplayer, but also
yourself.
As a...
Maybe it improve your confidence, it made you, more sociable.
Yeah, it does. Because like me attending event, all these things, like even like having this interview here, usually I'm really timid and shy. If not because of cosplay, I won't get this chance. And then, like I say, it pushes myself. It gave me confidence.
Steps out of your comfort zone.
Yeah. And it also, in some way, it helped me with my career also. Yeah, because with the confidence and also the opportunity, people seeing me, we get along, we talk, we network.
That's right. And I think the best part is when you get to connect with the people that are just like you, similar to you, and you feel like, oh my god, that's why cosplayers love it when there are all these cosplay events, because you get to meet people that would understand you. And they all like put in equal effort as you to come in, put up a great costume, I think next year, I might come back also as a cosplayer, who knows?
Okay, you can ask me for help.
Why not, Micho? I'm going to get your contact number from Vikri. I'm going to make sure that I will sit with you one whole day so you can tell me, okay, this character does this character does that. You can even play Dota with me and tell me about each character in Dota also.
I damn toxic in Dota. You will get scolded.
Lagi toxic, it's okay. Good.
Last time
lagi garang in a game, lagi I will go and approach.
Last
you.
Time I toxic until my friend's girlfriend uninstall Dota.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I'm very toxic.
Toxic to apa, Micho? I tak faham.
It means that you trash talk people, you
scold
people in game. Please don't do that, kids. Don't do that. It's bad. I'm like more chill and calm right now.
Okay, Micho, I take that my word lah. I don't want to play Dota anymore, I think, because I scared wait after this I'll get trash talked by Micho. I don't want. My career as a gamer will end as soon as I start.
Yes, I think so.
Yes. So no to Dota. But anyway, since Micho came here and put in so much effort to put up this costume, why not we show the whole look? So come. Oh. Well, clearly there's nothing to see from my end last. It's just Micho. Alright, Micho, there you go. 360, okay, let's do a 360 turn. Okay, come. More space for you. You're in the middle. Yes. Alright. Okay, turn a little bit. Turn. Yes. Uh-huh. Oh. Can we get some cheer from the crowd? Woo! Exactly. Thank you, everybody. There you go. This is an effort of months, guys. Months of planning and purchasing and altering. And this is the end product. Okay. You may take your seat again, Micho. Let me help you. No way. I'm sorry for the...
As a support, I don't have that strength to carry myself.
Okay, so, Now we know Micho as a cosplayer. Yes. We got into details about how you started, why you love it so much. Now we also know that you are also an avid gamer.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And I heard that this is not something that you just discovered recently, because you started gaming since you were 4.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
What made you fall in love with gaming at such a young age, Micho?
I guess it's thanks to my dad also. My dad is a gamer.
Is that right?
Yes. Back in 1993, there's this new release game called Doom.
Okay.
On PC. You know, back then it's like pixelated shooting game. And my dad was playing that and he left the PC on.
Okay.
And the setting is like the easiest level lah. So me as a kid, it's like 4 years old.
Hey, what is that? Curiosity of a child, right? What is this?
Yes, and I play it, and I actually like pass that stage.
Whoa.
Because it's like only like 1-2 monster I kill, and then yeah. So my dad actually found out.
Okay.
My dad saw me playing and saw me clear the stage, and he actually trained me the game.
Wow.
Yeah, it's funny. I mean,
this is amazing. Yeah, most of the time, you know, our parents are not really supportive of their children playing games. But in your case, from the start, from since you were 4. Your father was like, I see potential in my daughter and I'm going to train her and make sure she becomes a huge gamer, an amazing cosplayer, everything great in the gaming industry.
Yeah.
So, how did that bring you to where you are now? After that, what games you started playing?
Well, it's a bit long. Please, let me.
I got all day. Yeah. I want to listen to Micho's story.
So, because my dad like kind of trained me into gaming.
Yeah.
And that time also is the release of PlayStation 1.
Oh.
Yep.
Yeah, long time ago, right?
Yeah, long time ago. That's the time where gaming, PC gaming, PlayStation.
Just started to
boom. And then, so of course my dad as a gamer, he gets PS1 and he plays like Dragon Ball, those fighting game, shooting game, you control the aeroplane. I forgot what's the title, but it's like pew shoot monster.
That means you Tetris also tak main lah.
Since young, I play. Yeah, those like the one you use the toy gun thing.
I don't remember, but then
like that. That one I play also. So from there, I just continue to play. And then come PS2, PlayStation 2, PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4. Oh, I have it with my own money also.
Your own money when you were small?
Yeah. Well, not that small. At least like after I
made the PlayStation 2. Yeah, teenager already like that.
Yeah. But because my parents, my dad, only my dad, he plays and he got the PlayStation, so I continue to play. But now, whatever I want, I bought it with my own money.
Yeah.
And from there, my dad actually plays Dota 1. He's quite hooked up with the PC game. So Warcraft and Dota 1, he's really into it. He even like joined up with his uncle friends, to go for amateur tournament.
Wow.
He actually won third place in Penang.
Ooh.
Yeah, something like that. But
must be nice to see like the legacy lives on, you know, from your father, your uncle. And then you are playing Dota 2 now. It must be very special to see that the family, you know, it takes on the same passion and interest, right?
It helps my family to bond together, because one thing is that I actually come from a divorced family.
Right.
So me and my dad is a bit like hot temper guy and busy.
It's okay, my father was the same.
Yeah, I think a lot of Asian parents are like that.
Yeah.
But only through gaming that is the best memory I had with him. If not because of gaming, we might not have as many topics to talk about. It also brings me and my cousin and my brother together, because I started Dota 2, it's my brother who bring me in. He's like more active, so he like taught me how to play everything. So he actually brings my family together. My dad saw it, my dad is like, oh, you guys play? Oh, last time I played Dota 1. Oh. That's how we started the conversation. Yeah.
So your brother also mind game with you as well?
Yep. Very toxic.
Oh, very toxic.
Very toxic.
Oh my god.
Yeah,
toxic gamers are very scary.
My dad is toxic too, I think.
That's why. It's genetic.
Yeah.
Father, brother, sister, all kena. So maybe if I start playing, who knows, I might join you as a toxic gamer. Maybe.
Who knows? I think my dad is the one that would say, hey, even my grandma would play better than you.
Oh my god. Ooh, that hurts. Yep. That hurts.
Yep.
So right now, what games do you play? Dota 2?
Yeah, Dota 2 is still one of my most played games. But nowadays, a bit busy, so less play. Because I'm a working adult, so...
What do you work as?
I'm actually working in the event line. During Koyomi Festa, there's some of the booths I handle, set up for my movie distributor client. Yeah, so...
And how do you juggle your time as a gamer? And you have a full-time job?
What is sleep? have you ever seen the gaming character in the game sleep? No, we don't sleep. Even we die, we respawn.
You snooze, you lose.
Yep, correct.
I like that mantra, thank you. So now if I want to take a break and if I complain I'm tired, I got to remember what Micho said to me. Lah. No. Sleep is for the weak, guys.
Yep.
No, you snooze, you lose. So, but it must be really hard to juggle your job and
yes, game. It is very hard. Because besides my full-time job, like all these cosplay appearances, I did a lot of cosplay appearances for like brand, roadshow, all these things also. And because I'm quite active in the esports community,
yeah.
So often they might invite me as influencer or something like that to go on stage or what. So
you're
it's really
big
busy.
In the industry, yeah.
Well, not big, but I guess some people know me.
People know you, yeah. That's right.
So yes, I guess just try to cope up with everything, get one thing done at one time.
Yeah. But as a gamer, are you considered a professional gamer? Do you go for tournaments or do you just love playing games?
I actually simply love, but not thinking of going competitive and professional. I did participate in some sort of like small tournament with friends before, just for fun, like, as an experience. Yeah, but not thinking of going really.
Not thinking about it yet? Next year maybe, who knows, 2019, you might see Micho.
Who wants to get me? I think I'm doing okay in Mobile Legends and Dota 2 might need to train back, but okay.
What about, okay, you are a cosplayer, you are a gamer, are you not planning to maybe start becoming a caster or something? We don't have that many girl casters out there.
No, I'm actually too shy to do that, I think.
That's what they all say at the start, and then when they try it, they're like, oh god, I love the mic.
Yeah, maybe. That something can be considered. But besides caster, I think streamer also have like similar jobs.
Correct. Are you a streamer as well?
Actually, yes. Not so vivid, like, active yet, but I am. Recently, I've been selected for Wuntun as a selected streamer for their Karida launch challenge thing.
That is wonderful. Do you enjoy streaming?
Actually, I do because it gives me a platform to connect with my followers. To also like sometimes
you can interact with them.
Yeah, meet more friends or what to know that. Oh yeah, they're interested in like me playing games, seeing me be toxic or feeding or noob.
So that means as a streamer, put you are very mean, is it?
Depends on what game is it, but usually I'm trying not to be mean. I
control
try to
a bit. Nice. Because they can see your face when you're playing. Okay. Kind of like tone it down a little bit. Yeah, but your streaming style is macam mana? Are you like the funny kind? Are you very cool and calm, educational? How?
I think I actually curse quite a lot.
Odd?
On stream.
Is it?
Yes, so it's like those toot, toot.
A lot of the bleeps.
Apa,
nasib baik bukan on TV lah kan. Kalau on TV habis kena ban already lah. But on your stream, it's totally cool.
Yeah, but still try to refrain because especially like, let's say I stream Mobile Legends, there's a lot more like younger audience that's watching it because Mobile Legends, even 12 years old are watching it.
Really.
12 years old also, they can access to Facebook. So it's better to...
Very good. The kakak-kakak element, Micho ada lagi lah. She still thinks about the viewers who watch lah. Very good lah, Micho. So before we wrap up the segment, what do you hope to see in esports in 2019?
I guess because esports is like a very fast-growing industry in Malaysia, everyone actually wanted a piece of the cake or something like that. So sometimes people just jump in without understanding what is actually esports, what builds the community, and then they just wonder, okay, wow, a lot of money, wow, a lot of big brands, all this exposure. No, usually it started as a community of like really actual gamers and fans. It's the same like Comic Fiesta. It started organized by fans also, by fans for fans. So they should not forget what is the reason to bring everyone together. And you need to remember to also give back to the community before you want to take something like, let's say, your the money, the consumer money or what. So it's better to keep that in mind, to remember like what can you do to offer to the community to make it better.
What value can you add to the community?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Because, yes, there's definitely a lot more tournament and opportunity gonna happen in 2019. But don't forget why we started it, why the gamers started it and built it into a like $1 billion industry.
Yes. And I think to add to what you said, I believe that it is a huge misconception of people out there to think that, you know, esports or gaming is all about having fun. Because all these gamers, they spend so many hours in a day just to train, you know, to prepare for tournaments, to become better at their strategy. So you need a lot of discipline, hard work, and patience is very much important to become just like Micho. All right, Micho. Very touched. Last but not least, any tips you can give to those of them who wants to start cosplaying?
I guess because cosplay for a lot of us we to cosplay the character we love or to bring the character from a series we love.
Correct.
So it's better that you start from something you are familiar with, which is something you love,
yeah.
And it's easier for you to like build the things up so you know what you want to like let the audience around you see when you like cosplaying, yeah, that character. Instead of simply like pick a character, oh, it looks nice, but it's still work that
way. Cool.
Yeah, cosplay is for fun. You, yeah, want to do, you can do it even if you're not a follower, you're not a gamer, yeah, of this particular series or what. But
you have the connection,
yeah,
with the character.
It's more fun. It's fun, more fun. But like, when you cosplay a character, so people see, hey, Crystal Maiden.
Yes. You can just talk about the character because you know and you like the character.
It's really fun that
heart.
Way. Yes. I like. Like you are, I say Dota, you're like, apa ni? Oi.
That one this year lah, next year make sure you see ah. I will love Dota already. Yeah. I will come as one of the Dota characters.
Say one,
okay.
Ah.
If I were to become a Dota character, which one would I be?
Since you're so handsome.
Oh, you.
Anti-mage lah, anti-mage.
And what? Handsome and what?
Anti-mage. There's a guy called Anti-mage. It's a hard carry character.
Okay.
So basically, you need use him to farm a lot and then you kill everyone.
Farm a lot?
Yeah, farm means that you kill the creep to earn the money.
I thought farming. Sini abang saya tak main Dota, kata
farm. Oh, yeah. There's a specific term. You earn the money by killing the creep or what, yeah.
So that, how do you spell that? I'm going to Google it out after this.
It's actually farming, like the farmer farming.
F-A-R-M-A-I-G.
Yep,
M-I-N-G, yeah?
Yep, farming. Correct.
I will search that up. Oh, hello there. Looks like we've got one fan of Micho. Hello to you too.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Korea. I love you so much. And thank you very much, Micho, for joining us here, Micho. Yeah. Micho, I want to shake your hand. You want to shake my hand?
Yeah, the one I don't want to shake hand because with my non-player.
Tapa, I might join Micho at next year's Comic Fiesta as Farming Hero.
Anti-mage.
The character, very handsome.
Oh,
I will come back next year.
I see.
I will come back stronger, handsomer, and definitely in my cosplay costume next year. Mm-hmm. Great time with Micho. Thank you for watching, everybody. Don't go anywhere because we have two more live streaming only on My Game On's Live Streaming Lounge.
Bye-bye. See you guys next time.
Ooh.
Semarakkan semangat keusahawanan bersama aplikasi permainan Macun's Adventure. Muat turun di Google Play Store dan App Store.
Mau nak jadi jutawan?
Dah bersedia untuk cabaran sebenar? Sertailah Night Stream. Permainan tanpa jalan, tanpa had. Fungsi kawalan sepenuhnya. Inilah cabaran sebenar. Inilah Night Stream, permainan larian generasi baru yang anda nantikan.
Attention! Attention! To all gamers out there, check this out!